Hello everyone, in this video we will be solving Cambridge IGCSE ICT paper 2. This is the variant 2-1 of year May-June 2020. This paper consists of document production, data manipulation and presentations. Document production has already been done and uploaded. You can see the link in the description. In this video I will be doing data manipulation, which is done using the software Microsoft Access. So we are doing this task, task 3, database. These are the files required for the task. This is the evidence document, which has been prepared during the document production. Using a suitable database package, import the file J2120Race. So open Access. Click on blank database. Save the database in your folder. J2021. Click OK. Now the database is saved. Click on Create. Now this table is not required as we are importing the files, so close this. Now external data, new data source from file, text file. In the old versions of Access, it will be given here, external data, text file will be shown here itself. So text file, browse the folders, choose your folder. Race, we have to import race. Open. Okay, this is a CSV file. Always this option must be selected, delimited, because this is for comma separated fields. Click on next. First row contains field names in order to set the field names here. Next. Next, set the primary key. So choose my own primary key. In this primary key is entry ID. So set entry ID as the primary key. Click on advanced. Now we will set the data types. So the data type is given. From entry ID to cat code, it is text. All are text. Birth date is date with time. Age with Jan is numeric integer. Lapse is numeric integer. Race time is date and time. Event rank is text. All these are number, boolean. So you can see long integer, date with time. This is text. These two are numbered. Now license must be boolean. Boolean means yes or no value. So select yes or no from here. This has to be done from here. Otherwise the boolean data will not work properly. So license is boolean logic. Give OK, then next, click on finish. Close this. Your table is imported now. Now go to the design view, right click, design view. We'll set the formatting now. Now age, Jan and lapse is integer. It's already integer, you can see it is integer. Then time, date and time, race taken must follow the format HHMMSS. So race time, you click here, go to the format. In format, you have to select this format, the long time. This is the HHMMSS. So long time is the format which we require. Then points and race numbers are integer. Points and race number, they are already integer. Now license is boolean, it should be displayed as yes or no. So in order to set that, you should click on format. In license, click on format, you have the option yes or no. So select yes or no here, then only yes or no will be displayed, otherwise -1 and 0 will be displayed in the database. So we have set the fields and field types. Now save the table. Now place in your evidence document a screenshot showing the primary key, field names and data types. So this is the this screenshot we have to show using the snipping tool. When you are taking the screenshot, make sure the table name and the key symbol which represents the primary key is shown. So in evidence 5, what is evidence 5? Evidence 5, you have to paste your screenshot of the table. Now next, import the file categories.csv. So external data from file, text file, browse categories. Okay, next, same process. First row contains field names. Next, here the primary key is cat code. So cat code, next, choose my own primary key. Cat code must be the primary key. Then next, click on advanced to set the data type. You can see all our text, nothing much to change. So give OK, click on finish. So the table is here, you can see this is the table. This is the data in the table. Create a one-to-many relationship between cat code in the categories table and cat code in the race table. So in order to create the relationship, this you can close. For the relationship, click on database tools, relationships. Add the tables, add. Now you can see the cat code in this table, in categories table, is the primary key, and the cat code in race table is the foreign key. So we'll create a relationship between this, drag this cat code, drag and drop it on this cat code so that the relationship is created. The relationship type is one to many. Click on create. So this is the relation. In order to take the screenshot, you have to show the type of relationship also. So just right click, edit relationship, or double click on the line. So this will show the type of relationship. You have to take the screenshot. Relationship screenshot. As evidence 6. This is evidence 6. Now step 22. Enter the following details as a new record in the race table. So save the relationship and close this. Now open the race table. We have to enter the data which is given. So if you click here, new, click on new, you will get a new record. We can add the new record. First data is entry ID and the name Britain Jamie. Entry ID. Which is club is bike runners. This is the cat code. Birth date is birth date you have to copy. Next 61 4. So 61, here it will be 4. Now the time is, you have to copy this time sorry, you have to enter this time. The next event rank is 5, 90, 1, 1, 6, 2. So 5, 90, 1, 1, 6, 2, and the data is yes. Yes. So the record has been entered. Check for any data entries there. Since we copied and pasted, there is no error. Now you can save this. Now next, using fields from both tables, produce a tabular report. So in order to make the report, before that we have to produce the query with the required conditions. So first let us make the query. Create query design, add both the tables, make sure all the fields are visible here. Select the records where ability is elite. Select the records where ability is elite or expert. So ability, first we have to choose ability. Just double click ability here. Then gender is female, so I'll select gender. License is yes, select license. Okay, first let us give the criteria. Ability is elite or expert, female, and yes. So ability is elite or expert. Gender is female and license is yes. Click on run and check whether the conditions are working. Yeah, it is working. Now go to the design view. Now let us continue. Show only the fields: first name, last name, gender, club, license. First name, last name, gender, club, license. Gender we have already selected. Club, license we have already selected. Points and ability. Ability is also selected here. Points. In this order. That means when we make the report, we have to make sure this is in this order. So here we'll just select the fields and keep. When you are making the report, we will. When we are making the report, we will add the fields in this order. So here, the query is ready. Save the query. Right click, save. The query for step 23. So query for step 23, so that it is easy to understand. Now we'll make the report for this. So create, here you can close, create report wizard, add the fields in the order. So click here, make sure you select the query. Now according to the question, first name, last name, gender, club, license, points, ability. Gender, club, license, points, and then ability. This is the order. Points and in this order. Do not group the data. The data is sorted into descending order of points. Next, there is no grouping here. No grouping. Now sorting, if you do from here, the order will change in the report. So in order to make it stay as it is, we will not do the sorting from here. we can do the sorting from here also, but the order of the fields will change. So I'll do it from the report. It must be portrait. So it is portrait. Fits on a single page that we'll set after making the report. Includes only the text top ability females. So next, the title is top ability females. Click on finish so that you can see the preview of the report. Now the sorting we have to do sorts the data into descending order of points. So this is the points for descending order. Go to the design view. You have group and sort. Click here, group and sort. Then you can see here add sort option is there. Click on add a sort. The fields will be there. Select points. Select points and it is descending order. So from largest to smallest. Now you can see the report view. Now the data has been sorted in descending order. Now you have to add your name. According to the question, you have to add your name, center number and candidate number on the report. So in order to make the name appear on every page, I will add it here in the page footer. I'll remove this date and time. Click on a label box, this one. This is the label box. Type your name, candidate number, and sender number. Now press Ctrl A. Some fonts are in gray in color. It's always better to make it black so that it's more clear. The text color, make it black so that it is completely clear. Now all the steps are done. Go to the layout view. Make sure everything is visible. Layout view. Now you can see here the first name. It's taking more space. So select the field name as well as the data by pressing the control key. Reduce the width. Same case here. Reduce the width. Move it here so that we have enough space. So everything is clear now. This is the report. So you can see the print preview. There is one page. This is the report. So save the report. So this is the first report. Print out two. You have to print the report. Now next one. Using fields from both tables, produce a tabular report. So this is another report. So we'll make another query. Create query design. Add both the tables. So first we have to give the condition. Select the records where club includes the text bike. So we need the fields. Club, age Jan, event rank. Now the conditions will be given. Club includes the text bike. It has the text bike. So in order to show inclusion, we'll use the wildcard character star. bike 40 or more, not DNF. So includes the word bike. So star bike star, I will enter. So the system will set it as like bike star. Now age is greater than or equal to 4 and event rank is not DNF. So you can either use the symbol not or type the boolean operator, sorry, logical operator not. Not DNF. Sorry, this is greater than or equal to 40. Give 4 greater than or equal to 40. Now click on run and see whether it is working. So we have all the fields here. All the clubs which contains the word bike is here. Now go to the design view. Contains a new field called lap time, which is calculated at runtime and displayed as integer. This field will calculate the average time per lap. In order to calculate average time per lap, multiply race time by 1440 and divide by the number of laps. Multiply race time. So lap time is 1440 multiplied by 1440 and divided by the number of laps. So divided by number of laps. So number of laps is laps. It must be formatted as integer. So design view. Click on lap time. Format must be set it as general number with no decimal place as it has to be integer. Design view. When you are setting the decimal point, even though I have set decimal point here, your values are here, you can see decimal points are being shown. So let us make format as fixed. Yeah, now the lap time is shown in integers. Next, shows only the fields last name, first name, gender. So last name, first name, gender, age Jan, that we have already taken here, category, club, event, rank. Event rank is already here, club is already here. We have to add only category, event rank, license, race time and lap time. License, race time and lap time. Race time, lap time is already here. These are the fields required. This also must be in this order when you are making the report. Now next, everything has to be done from the report, from sorting onwards. So I will save the query. Save. This is step 24 query. Query 2. Step 24. So if you click run, this is the required data. Now save this. Create report wizard. You have to select step 24 query. Now first name, last name. The order must be maintained. Gender, age and category, club. Gender, age and category, club. Event rank, license, race time and lap time. Then next, make sure it's not grouped. Then next, no grouping must be there. Now click on next. We have to sort according to ascending order of gender, then descending order of age and. So sorting I'm not doing from here. Click next. It must be landscape. So select landscape. Next. The text. This text must be as the title. So set the title here. There is a formatting is here. We'll do it from the report. So click on finish. This is the preview of the report. This must be 28 point serif font. So go to the design view. Select on home tab. Set the size as 28. Serif font. Times New Roman. Make this black. Set all the text to black color. We have to do the sorting which we had left behind. Ascending order of gender, then descending order of age and. Ascending order of gender. So click on design, group and sort, add sort. So you have to choose gender, ascending order, so A on top. Then next sort, so click on add a sort. It must be age Jan and it must be in descending order. Age Jan must be in descending order. So descending order, you have to set it as from largest to smallest. So this is the sorting. Now calculates the average age and displays this as an integer below the age Jan column. So select age Jan. This is age Jan. You can see select this one. Then click on totals here. We have average. Click on average. So the formula will appear in the report footer. You can see they have asked you to set a label average age of veterans to the left of this value. So increase this a little bit. Then choose a label to the left of this. Paste it here. You can make this black. includes only your name, sender number and candidate number in the footer of the report, so it appears on every page. So in the footer, this is the footer with no other data displayed. So in the footer, you have to remove this. This is the time and page number. So select this, select on the border and then delete it. Delete this. Now take a label box. Draw a label box. Type your name, candidate number, sender number. Save and print your report. So first let us check the layout view. This is the layout view. You can see some of the data is outside the border. So like we did in the previous report, select this. Increase the width to show the complete field name. Make sure the data is completely visible. Make this wide. Lap time is shown here, it's very small, that's why it's not appearing there. Just make it big. Go to the layout view again. So move this here. So now everything is fit inside the page. The average value must be, the average must be set as an integer. So this is your average. Click on this, on design, property sheet, set the decimal place to 0. And the format, make this fixed, fixed dot standard, then it will work. So this is the average age here. You can see the print preview. So there are two pages. Now next, save and print your report. So this report has to be printed. Now, evidence 7, place in your evidence document a screenshot showing the database formula to calculate the average age. So, for the average age, go to the design view. We have the formula here. Make sure this is completely visible, the screenshot. Take the screenshot for this formula. That is evidence 7. So this is the formula for average age. Export the report created in step 24 in a PDF format. So save the report. You can close all. Now this is your report by club veterans. So right click. In order to set it as PDF, right click, export. PDF. You can see the option PDF here. Save inside your folder. Save with the same name. Click on publish. So now you can see this is the PDF file. Place in your evidence document a screenshot to show the exported file saved in your work area. Make sure there is evidence of the file type. So this is your folder. You can see here this is your PDF file. Then you take the screenshot. This is your evidence 8. So this is the end of the database task. Next one is mail merge, which I'll be uploading. You can check the link in the description. So please like, share, and comment. I'll be coming with more videos. Thank you for now.